Congregation, please stand.
I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die. Friends and those watching on live stream, welcome to the funeral Thanksgiving service for the life of Professor Dr. Samuel J.M. Sivaratnam. Please be seated. Some words from St. Paul. I am convinced that neither death, nor life, nor angels, nor rulers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor powers, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord. Well, it is with sadness, but also gladness and in indeed joy that I am honoured to take this service today. Sadness, yes, because we all love Samuel, or J.M., as many of you will know watching from Sri Lanka or Malaysia or Australia or wherever you're watching from. We hope that the broadcast is working well today. A big warm welcome to you all today. Also, those who knew Samuel, those who cared for him, a warm welcome to you too. Sadness because it is difficult to let go of those we love and who loved us. And it was very much a two-way relationship with Samuel. He gave and he received and we received too. Sadness also because Samuel also had an ambition to come to this beautiful church, but has never succeeded until this day. But what a time, Eastertide, with these beautiful Easter flowers adorning the cross of salvation he most sincerely believed in. We also feel especially the sadness that Joseph and Jay are now experiencing. Joseph, because he cared for Samuel to honour his dear father, but also Jay, being so many miles away, must be feeling bereft not being able to be here in person, and so we pray for them and for each other. Sadness, yes, but gladness too, because so soon after we have as Christians experienced the darkness, emptiness and sadness of Good Friday, we are an Easter people who believe wholeheartedly in the resurrection. And so although in our hearts and minds we miss Samuel, in our souls and spirit we thank God that Samuel is now experiencing the divine bliss, joy and peace of the love of Jesus in all its fullness in heaven. We have some wonderful readings that promise hope of eternal life with our Lord, and some brilliant hymns too, which also promise the same. But I'm afraid those in this church are unable to sing, but only hum behind their masks. And I will try my best to lead you in those hymns accompanying our beloved Les on the piano. But of course, you at home on live stream can sing out loud, but your accompaniment won't be heard by us, but will be by the angels in heaven. So I do encourage you to sing out today. But first, let's use the formal liturgy for this service, and then I'll lead us in our first hymn, which are all on the order of service which you should have before you. Let's first, though, pray. We meet in the name of Jesus Christ, who died and was raised to the glory of God the Father. Grace and mercy be with you. We've come here today to remember before God our brother Samuel, to give thanks for his life, to commend him to God, our merciful Redeemer and Judge, to commit his body to be cremated, and to comfort one another in our grief. We're reminded that Jesus Christ himself was moved to tears at the grave of Lazarus, his friend. And so we ask God to look with compassion on us, his children, in our loss, to give to troubled hearts the light of hope and strengthen in us the gift of faith in Jesus Christ our Lord. And so we pray, Almighty God, you judge us with infinite mercy and justice and love everything you have made. In your mercy, turn the darkness of death into the dawn of new life and the sorrow of parting into the joy of heaven through our Saviour, Jesus Christ. Amen. So if you'd like to stand now, those who are able, to sing our first hymn, What a Friend We Have in Jesus.
All our sins and grief to bear. What a privilege to carry everything to God in prayer. Oh, what peace we often forfeit. Oh, what needless pain we bear. All because we do not carry everything to God in prayer. Have we trials and temptations? Is there trouble anywhere? We should never be discouraged. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Can we find a friend so faithful who will all our sorrows share? Jesus knows our every weakness. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Are we weak and heavy laden? Cumbered with a load of care. Precious Saviour, still our refuge. Take it to the Lord in prayer. Do thy friends despise, forsake thee? Take it to the Lord in prayer. In his arms he'll take and shield thee. Thou wilt find a solace there.
Would you please be seated? And I'm going to invite Pam up to lead our first reading, Psalm 23.
Psalm of David, Psalm 23. He maketh me lie down in green pastures. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He leadeth me beside the still waters. He restoreth my soul. He leadeth me in the paths of righteousness for his name's sake. Yea, though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil. For thou art with me, thy rod and thy staff, they comfort me. Thou preparest a table before me in the presence of mine enemies. Thou anointest my head with oil, my cup runneth over. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever. Thanks be to God.
Thank you so much, Pam. I'm going to invite Joseph, and later on Jenny's going to lead some of the eulogy this morning. Joseph.
Dear family and friends, thank you very much for being here this morning. Thank you also for the love, the kindness, and support that you have given me during this very difficult time. My father, Dr. Samuel J.M. Sivaratnam, was a man of great compassion and principle. He was a wonderful husband to my beloved mother. He was a caring father to me and my brother, Jayantha. An amazing grandfather to his three granddaughters and their families. My father was an intellectual. His knowledge of English literature, world history, geography, science, and general knowledge were exemplary. He was an excellent sportsman, an excellent cricket, and loved to watch tennis, snooker, and athletics. My father was a compassionate man. He became a surgeon to help mankind. And not for any financial gain or self-glory. In Sri Lanka, he had patients come to his home for medical consultations, and he would not take a single penny from them. He was quite content to receive his salary as a surgeon from the local government hospital. My father was a humble man who was not in the least interested in pomp and ceremony or a showy lifestyle. But where we, his family, was concerned, he gave us the very best with so much of love. Thank you, Daddy, for all that you have done for us. We love you and will continue to love you and Mommy for the rest of our lives. Before I finish, I want to thank Jenny White for all the support that she gave to my father. I also wish to give thanks to my father's wonderful carers who are here today. Anna and her husband Alex, Florin and his wife Mihaila, who took great care of my father as if he was their own grandfather. Thank you. Because of the pandemic, my family was unable to be here today. But I know that each of them is here in spirit to give me the strength as I stand here alone saying goodbye to my precious father on his earthly body is sent on his final journey from this world. Thank you, my darling daddy, for everything. Your ever-loving son, Joseph Pradeep Kumar. There are a few more tributes actually, one from his nephew in Sri Lanka and the other one from his niece in London. This is from Daniel Sivaratnam from Sri Lanka, my father's nephew. My earliest recollection of J.M. Uncle was of a stately, handsome young doctor, naturally attired in pure white satin drill, full suit, leaving for work. He had just returned from the UK after qualifying himself as a surgeon and was posted to Batticaloa General Hospital. Those were the days when doctors were respected not merely for their noble profession, but more so for their personal ethics and values. J.M. Uncle gained much respect and popularity wherever he served, not only because he was a caring and skillful surgeon, but because he was one of those very few specialists who officially opted not to engage in private practice, but to treat all his patients with equal care in the hospital. I believe that selfless breed of specialists are rare and extinct. J.M. Uncle was a principle-centered, value-driven person, fiercely loyal and proud of his ancestry in Jaffna, the northern part of Sri Lanka. Apart from being a very skilled surgeon, he was an artist. He was an expert at engraving intricate art on copper. He had produced many a masterpiece. As my father's eldest brother, we revered him as the patriarch of the Sivaratnam family. He was a loving husband to my darling aunt, who was indeed a great and lovely lady, an excellent cook. I believe she has passed on those culinary skills to her three granddaughters. Jayamankal had a glorious innings with his two sons, with Jayanthan and Pradeep, which is myself, and grandchildren doting on him. Jayanthan and Pradeep looked after him very lovingly with much loving care and dedication. While they were preparing to celebrate his 100th birthday, our Lord wanted that rare privilege and took him away peacefully. We thank God for the life, service, and example of a great man, to our family and to humanity as a very skillful surgeon. May he rest in peace until we meet again on that beautiful show. Daniel Vasanthan Sivaratnam, his nephew from Sri Lanka. There's one more from me, please. It's my father's niece from London. This is from Ranji Pavan, niece of Samuel James Sivaratnam. It was with great sadness I heard of the passing away of our darling Jayam Mama. Now, for those of you who must be wondering what that means, Jayam is his middle name, and Mama is Tamil for uncle. I am Ranji Pavan, the third daughter of Jayam Mama's loving sister, Grace and Daniel. In fact, I am one of eight children, and I speak for all my siblings, as I know all of them share the same sentiments. We are all blessed for having known him, for having loved him, and been loved by him. When Joseph phoned and gave me the sad news, the first thought that came to my mind was the banyan tree of our family has fallen. Yes, our darling Jay Mama is the last to leave the world from our parents' generation. As such, all of us in our generation looked up to him as our loving second father. He is someone who never forgot our birthdays. Our birthdays always started with his loving blessings. He was genuinely interested in our progress and well-being. We admired him for his sincerity, honesty, and integrity. Personally speaking, my first memory of him was seeing him as a bridegroom. I remember attending their wedding as a little girl and thinking this was a fairy tale wedding. Our Jay Mama was such a tall, handsome prince, and our Atpudam auntie, which is my mum, was a beautiful princess. Growing up, I realized he was not only a handsome man, but also a well-read, knowledgeable, fine surgeon. I have heard what a clever and caring doctor he was from many of his colleagues. I was told he had been an inspiration for a few family and friends to become doctors. One of my favorite memories of our Jay Mama was when he and our auntie visited us in Jersey, Channel Islands. I had the privilege of celebrating his 80th birthday. We hosted a dinner party and invited a few of our friends. He was immaculately dressed up for the evening, wearing a suit and tie, looking a thorough gentleman, as he always was. He surprised our friends, who were all doctors, with his knowledge, his wealth of knowledge in medicine. Though he was a retired doctor, he was up to date with current procedures as he was updating himself, reading all the medical journals. During his time of practice, he had not performed any keyhole surgeries and was keen to witness one. So that too was arranged for him, and he was very happy indeed and satisfied having had the opportunity of seeing one performed. The other matter that surprised me was his knowledge of the Bible. We had the opportunity of having some meaningful discussions, and he had answers for the many questions we had on spiritual matters. There is so much more I can say, but the time given to me doesn't allow it. Now, this is for me, from my sister. Darling Joseph, this is for you. Both you and Jay were two wonderful, caring children. You took care of your parents so willingly and lovingly. After your mummy passed away and your daddy came to live with you, you took great care of daddy single-handedly. Especially, the last week was so difficult for you. We know you tried your very best, to save your daddy's life. But God saw our Jai Mama was getting weak and tired. So he put his arms around him and took him away in his sleep. How we wish we could have all been there to give our last respects to our precious Jai Mama, but unable to do so because of the pandemic restrictions. However, we take this opportunity to honor our darling Jai Mama and say he will never be forgotten, but always be loved deeply and remembered by us all. Finally, I like to say, our Jai Mama is a winner once again, even now. According to the song, I Can Only Imagine. Whilst we are still imagining, our Jai Mama has finished his race and has seen the Lord. He is already singing Hallelujah together with his precious wife and all his loved ones who are gone before him. I thank everyone here for your presence and your support for our loving brother, Joseph. Jenny, please.
These are from the three grandchildren in Australia. The first one is from Gail Cuckoo. Sorry, Lucky. Can I go a bit forward? I can't see. Can I pull it forward a bit more?
Yeah, of course. Hang on, let me do it. If you like it forward a little bit.
Yeah, okay. It's a dark shadow over it. Thank you.
Okay. Is that all right?
Yeah. Oh, dear me. This is from my papa. Papa, you brought me up from the age of two until I married. Everything I owe today, it is through you. Papa, you and Amma, grandmother, were my world, and you left us suddenly, and my heart is broken. I will miss you so much. I cherish all that I have from you have taught me through my childhood years right up to now. I will never forget the time when you went through my computer syllabus to help me and learn of my computer, just as to help me with the preparation of my exams. When I decided to switch over from the field of computers into the world of nursing, you also coached me over the phone concerning the autonomy of the human body for my nursing course. I love you, Papa. Thank you for being you. This is from Joanne Cuckoo. Thank you so much for joining my family to celebrate the life of Professor Samuel J.M. Sivanathram, a man I am proud to call my grandfather. I remember Papa used to study my books and make sure my notes to teach me. My papa is the cleverest person I have ever come across. He not only taught me to study, he also taught me both some general knowledge. Thank you, Papa, for your love and kindness. With lots of love from your granddaughter, Cuckoo. A tribute from Salome. Darling Papa, your wisdom and your knowledge and kindness will be greatly missed, especially by my children. I remember I always used to say to me, early to bed, early to rise, makes a man healthy, wealthy and wise. I will pass this on to my children, Papa. You also taught me that great people like you can be loving, caring and very humble. You were a great surgeon, Papa, but also a very humble human being. I shall always miss you, Papa, and we'll meet again. Your loving granddaughter, Salome.
Well, thank you for all those wonderful tributes. Let's just have a moment of quiet just as we let some of those words sink into our hearts, shall we? Well, the world has indeed lost a great man, and those who knew him well will be sadly missing his passing. Psalm 23, though, acts as the perfect antidote to the situation that we have and we find ourselves in today. In the same way that Jesus cried out on the cross at Good Friday, and here's our Good Friday cross here, adorned with the crown of thorns and the beauty of these roses representing his bloodshed on the cross, we're reminded of that Good Friday moment when on the cross he uttered the words from Psalm 22, the psalm before the one we've just had read by Pam, Psalm 23, "The Lord's my shepherd," when he cried out, my God, why have you forsaken me? Why are you so far from saving me, so far from the words of my groaning? Oh my God, I cry out by day, but you do not answer, by night, and am not silent. Now this must be a cry of so many of us when we feel desolate, when we're feeling despairing, confused, or troubled in life. And it is in many ways the cry of the world. And King David, the author of these Psalms, certainly felt this as many times in his life. Just read, very appropriately, just read 1 and 2 Samuel. Yet, as verse 3 begins, and what an appropriate word that is. It signifies a change, a bit like when we read the word therefore in the New Testament, yet in this psalm from the Old Testament. Yet you are enthroned, as the Holy One David writes. In you our fathers put their trust. They trusted and you delivered them. When we have that relationship with God, just as King David did, the world changes. However dire, desolate, or despairing, or troubled the world can be, when we have that level of trust, we always have an eternal hope. And so King David moves from the desolation of Good Friday to Psalm 23, the resurrection story of the Old Testament. The Lord is my shepherd. How powerful that is. And so opportune that the Lord Jesus Christ in John's Gospel said, I am the good shepherd. And that should put our despair, our diseases, our lack of ease, if you like, put that to rest immediately. If our Lord Jesus is the good shepherd and we are the sheep, and we know that he will put the 99 into the sheep pen and go looking even for the most wayward of sheep, however unbelieving or skeptical our faith is, this story should inspire us at least to look into a relationship of faith in God through Jesus. Samuel, though, had a deep and amazing faith. We have some of his carers here today, and I know he always took the opportunity, did he not, to, despite his physical restrictions and at times pain, to share how good God is and how you should place your trust in him. He was a great evangelist. He was also a great prayer. I gave him at least one olive wood cross from the Holy Land, which along with some others, I think he cherished and used to pray. So much of Samuel's life, as we've heard in these excellent eulogies, so much as we've heard, he had a life of green pastures and still waters in those early days when he qualified as a surgeon, went back to Sri Lanka and was respected. But you know, like us all, there are times when we are led through the valley of the shadow of death. And even quite recently, he became infected with COVID, but survived. A couple of years ago, his kidney count went down below the impossible level, but he survived. I can imagine him saying under his breath, "Even though I walk through the valley of the shadow of death, I will fear no evil, for you, Lord, are with me." A man of amazing faith. This faith was rewarded with an overflowing of God's anointing talent in his profession, where he would pray for the patients he was operating on before each operation. "You anoint my head with oil, my cup overflows." And then this promise of everlasting life. "Surely goodness and love will follow me all the days of my life, and I will dwell in the house of the Lord forever." What a wonderful promise. The same promise Jesus makes for us 1,000 years later in the Gospels. And what more, he came back to demonstrate this wasn't an empty hope, but a real, realistic and true promise. And over 500 witnesses profess their eyewitness testimony. How good is that? Samuel truly believed this. He may have felt at times, particularly in those last difficult years, my God, why have you forsaken me at times? But that's only being real and human. But the antidote to that is the words of the Good Shepherd, when he says, fulfilling the closing words of Psalm 23, these words I used as I entered the church. "I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Those who believe in me, even though they die, will live. And everyone who lives and believes in me will never die." That reading from John 11 goes on. Do you believe this? And I challenge everybody who's watching, do you believe this? If you don't, let's just take a moment to let God speak to you today. He might be nudging you to open your heart to him. Let's just pause for a moment. Just if he's doing that through my words today, through Samuel's witness and testimony, let's just see if he wants to nudge you, and we'll pick that up again in the prayers in a moment. But if you do believe, let the words that John is going to now read in a moment resonate with you as yet another promise of the life to come. But first, I just want to end with the collect for the funeral service. So let us pray. Merciful Father, hear our prayers and comfort us. Renew our trust in your Son, whom you raised from the dead. Strengthen our faith that all who have died in the love of Christ will share in his resurrection, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Over to you, John, with some more words of hope from the book of Revelation.
The second reading is from the last book of the Bible, the book of Revelation, chapter 21. And I'm going to read the first 7 verses. "And I saw a new heaven and a new earth, for the first heaven and the first earth were passed away, and there was no more sea. And I, John, saw the holy city, New Jerusalem, coming down from God out of heaven, prepared as a bride adorned for her husband. And I heard a great voice out of heaven saying, Behold, the tabernacle of God is with men, and he will dwell with them, and they shall be his people, God himself shall be with them and be their God. And God shall wipe away all tears from their eyes, and there shall be no more death, neither sorrow nor crying. Neither shall there be any more pain, for the former things are passed away. And he that sat upon the throne said, Behold, I make all things new. And he said unto me, Write, for these words are true and faithful. And he said to me, It is done. I am Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end. I will give unto him that is athirst of the fountain of the water of life freely. He that overcometh shall inherit all things, and I will be his God, and he shall be my son. Thanks be to God.
Thank you, John. We're going to have a short time of prayer now as we give thanks for Samuel's life, ask for God to bring comfort to all who mourn, and give you the opportunity to also respond if you don't know Jesus in your heart to live in the life light of eternity. So let's just bow our heads in prayer. I'm going to use the bidding, Lord, in your mercy. If you'd like to respond, hear our prayer. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. God of mercy, Lord of life, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for Samuel, for the grace and mercy he received from you, for all that was good in his life, and for the memories we treasure today. Just bring before God any special memory we have of Samuel now, a personal one. I've heard so much about this great man. Just bring it before the Lord now. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. Father, you promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good this your servant Samuel, as we also remember him. And bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sins have been forgiven and death is no more. We just bring our own lives before God. Say sorry to God for anything that we have left undone, we feel we should have done. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now we pray for those who mourn, particularly remembering Joseph and Jay, for all those around the world who are watching us now, members of the family who have been able to make it here, as Joseph has already said, those who are with us in spirit. Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Look in mercy on all who mourn, especially remembering Joseph and Jay, and this Samuel's large family. Give all who mourn patient faith in times of darkness, and strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And our prayer for readiness to live in the light of eternity, and this is a prayer of invitation for us all. Father, you are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal the memories of hurt and failure, and give us the wisdom and grace to use aright the time that is left to us here on earth to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy, hear our prayer. And now let us pray with confidence as our Saviour has taught us the words of the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And now those who are able, if you'd like to stand, please. So I say the prayer of commendation. As we commend Samuel Jem to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. God, our Creator and Redeemer, by your power, Christ conquered death and entered into glory, confident of his victory and claiming his promises. We entrust Samuel to your mercy in the name of Jesus, our Lord, who died and is alive and reigns with you now and forever. Amen. We've come to our closing hymn, that wonderful hymn, which is again another one of Samuel's favourites, How Great Thou Art. So let's please be led now by Les in this closing hymn. My God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the works thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander, and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur, and see the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. God his Son, not sparing, sent him to die, I scarce can take it in. On the cross, the burdens badly bearing, he bled to die, to take away my sin.
Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. With shouts of acclamation, and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then shall I bow in humble adoration, and then proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Saviour God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art.
Heavenly Father, in your Son Jesus Christ, you have given us a true faith and a sure hope. Strengthen this faith and hope in us all our days, that we may like those who believe in the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, and the resurrection to eternal life through our Lord Jesus Christ. And the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon us and remain with us always. Amen. Now we're going to be led out to some wonderful music. Just want to thank you all for coming here, those who are able to come personally. For those of you watching on live stream, thank you for tuning in today. And we do hope that you feel included and join with us in this act of thanksgiving. And a big thanks from Joseph here to us all with that traditional greeting and thanksgiving. I just want to pass on some news, because this is a kind of typical Church of England notices at the end of the service, really. But there are roadworks on the way into the crematorium, and so it's made it rather complicated. So what speaking with Neil earlier on, what we suggest you do is that we all follow the hearse and follow the route that they know to get into the crematorium successfully. If you try the usual way, or the way that your sat nav would take you, you might find yourself down a closed road at the moment. So we're all going to take it easy, and we'll all go in convoy. Okay, so let's now have this lovely closing piece of music from J.S. Bach, Toccata and Fugue in D minor.